Jim Schwartz. So the Lions beat the Bears 40-32.
He thinks he's an okay coach.
No, JR. Horrible.
I don't.
Horrible. Horrible.
Okay at best.
Horrible.
Horrible coach.
D. Horrible coach.
Why?
He's a bumbling fool, thinks that it confuses anger with, you know, being a winner and being tough, and he's a buffoon.
But he's friends with Kid Rock. How don't you understand this?
Thank you. Case closed.
So 40-32 win for the Lions.
It was a good win.
It was a good win, mainly, again, once aided by Jay Cutler being bad. He had four turnovers on
his own. But they did move the ball. There's no question the Lions moved the ball.
Running the ball.
Here's where both. First, let me say what my favorite part of that game was, because the Lions are so the Lions. The Lions are exactly the kind of team, I'm so glad I didn't bet on them, where your quarterback goes on a one-yard sneak and fumbles the ball. Mm-hmm. But look what happened.
Lance Briggs
it
pops
popped
it out.
Up in the air, and he caught it himself. Like, that was the most Lion play
Lefty.
Ever. Usually, safety picks it off and goes 102 yards, and you have a 14-point swing, and that's why you lose the game. The Lions' inability to do stuff like, so you could look at it and go, hey, maybe the Lions karma is changing. The ball landed back in Matthew Stafford's hands. I'll still take that by the end of the year, even if they sneak into the playoffs, that they will manage to prove their ineptitude.
Right, I agree. And those are the kind of plays that you screw up if you have a bad coach who doesn't teach all the details and stress the importance of getting everything precise and correct. And the Lions lead the league, or they're one of the league leaders in penalties and stupid penalties.
Right.
Just mind-boggling, dumb penalties. And that is really a reflection of the coach.
With all that talent on offense and significant talent on defense, by the way, they would be lucky to go 8-8. If they were coached by a Harbaugh, they would be in the NFC Championship game.
Now, would we be saying that if the Patriots lost yesterday? Because they fumbled the snap.
Yeah, Tom Brady's he's the best 4th-and-inches quarterback in the NFL history. You go 96-4. We saw one of the losses.
He's 70-for-74.
Right. Yeah.
So third and one or fourth and one.
Yeah. So
yeah,
whatever.
Incredible
stuff. It's pretty impressive.
You give him a break. I'll tell you what Jim Schwartz gets credit for. And we were talking about this before the show started.
Yes.
Is that you mentioned Reggie Bush earlier and Pete Carroll not using him in the big play. Jim Schwartz looks like maybe the first coach who's figured out how to use Reggie Bush, because that is a dynamic player who is fantastic in the open field. They're getting the ball. Reggie Bush looked like he was 22 years old on that touchdown run. And so I think it's worth giving them some credit for figuring that out.
18-for-139. I agree with you. But the offensive
and
line.
4-for-41 catching. I mean, he was
173 total yards.
Yeah.
The offensive line played great against a Bears defensive line that is without Henry Melton, who I think plays a bigger part than you think.
I can't tell if the Bears defense is really good or really horrible. I can't.
Well, against Reggie Bush, they're really bad.
Yeah, they're really bad.
They can't tackle.
I think they're an average defense that looks good because they're opportunistic
and they
score every turnover somehow.
Yeah.
But they're an average defense. You can move the ball on them.
I don't think they're average. I think they're definitely above average. I think they're pretty good because they find a way to take away the ball. There were just a few times where, look, Tillman punched out the ball and it unfortunately took a bad bounce and went out of bounds. They could have had two turnovers in that game.
Usually,
and that would have changed the game.
Turnovers among, you know, either competent teams, if you're not talking about the Jaguars, they balance each other out. Like, you know, if a team recovers almost all of the fumbles they lose in a given year, or a high percentage of them, that team's going to win most of their games. And that's just luck. The Bears seem to now be at like a 5-year run of really sort of creating things that makes me think that they're beyond luck. They know how to create turnovers.
They do. No, they do.
They do. But they also pay a small price for it. You know, a lot of times I see Tillman, instead of tackling that, trying to punch the ball out.
Oh, yeah.
And the guy gets another 15 yards. I mean, so that happens too.
Sure. Yeah. I mean, they're trying to teach it more and more. However, if your safeties and corners can't make those tackles, those big open field tackles, you see what Reggie Bush can do. So, by the way, what was I going to say? Chicago plays against New Orleans next week, and Detroit is at Green Bay. I guess that'll be the big test for Detroit as well.